Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke, Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. Also, please check out my new channel, The Rider King, which is basically a video channel that will be featuring my boy Roscoe, my new Rottweiler puppy. In my last video, I talked about my decision to take the Rottweiler as opposed to getting a Cane Corso for my family pet. In this video, what I want to talk about is why I chose the Rottweiler over the Doberman Pinscher. Let me first break down what it is that I'm looking for, or what I look for in my next family companion. What I wanted was a natural protector. I wanted a large dog breed, something that would do well in an urban, suburban community, a dog that's very loyal, a great family companion, a relatively healthy breed, a dog that would be well in a multi-dog family, and also a dog that would be child friendly. I have some small children that I love very much and would hate to have to put a dog out because he didn't get along with my children. So listening to my requirements, you may think that, hey, why didn't you get a Doberman Pinscher? Doberman Pinschers are great for that. And I will agree, the Doberman Pinschers do suit my needs. But the reason why I didn't choose a Doberman Pinscher is one, I discovered the Doberman Pinscher kind of late in life. What I mean by that is that I've seen them since I was young, but the ones that I saw were not impressive. They were, I guess, what you would call the American style or the American Doberman Pinscher. They were a little bit skinnier, narrower, and they had a bad reputation. I mean, a reputation that you would, you know, whether it would be in the movies or in the streets, you never really heard a lot of great things about Doberman Pinschers. It wasn't until recently, doing Dogumentary TV, that I came into contact with folks that had German or European style Doberman Pinschers, and these Doberman Pinschers were a lot bigger. Aesthetically, they suited me a lot better, and they were majestic. They were beautiful. They were big dogs, and I definitely, over the last 2.5 years, have come to really love and respect the Doberman Pinscher as a breed. If you guys watch Dogumentary TV, you've seen me film several videos with working Doberman Pinschers. And what I've discovered in these last 2 years is that this breed is not what I thought it was. It wasn't what they said it was in the movies. It wasn't a bad guy. And it was definitely not what they said about it in the streets. I wasn't a dog that wasn't going to turn around and be disloyal or bite its owner. To the contrary, I find it, I mean, in terms of my understanding of the breed, I'm impressed with how loving and sensitive the Doberman Pinschers are that I've come in contact with. So Doberman Pinschers are a great breed, definitely deserving of ownership. If I could own 100 dogs, you know, several of them would be Doberman Pinschers. But again, you know, I got the Rottweiler. And the reason why I got the Rottweiler is not because it's smarter than the Doberman Pinscher, but I think Doberman Pinschers are probably like elite in terms of intelligence and when it comes to purebred dog breeds. And the Doberman Pinscher is an incredible athlete. And like I said, in my experience, these dogs are amazing family companions, which is just something I never knew. But I came to the game kind of late and I didn't really know that. But there's still some advantages that I think the Rottweiler has over the Doberman Pinscher. One is health. I know some people think that the Rottweiler has a lot of health issues. I'm aware of the health issues facing the breed, but I have my own take on that, and I'll do a video about my take on the health issues facing many dog breeds, the Rottweiler included. But for the sake of this video, I think the Rottweiler is a healthier breed than the Doberman Pinscher. In terms of health, the big issue that I have with the Doberman Pinscher, the thing that worries me the most, is Wobbler syndrome. In addition to the health issues, I don't see the Doberman Pinscher that could work well in a multi-dog family. Well, I've seen a Doberman Pinscher get along with a French Bulldog, but I haven't really seen a Doberman Pinscher get along with another large, powerful breed. So I don't know that that's possible. I'm sure there's probably someone out there that has an example of that. And I don't discredit it. I'm just saying from my experience, that was one of the things I found, that the Rottweiler is a dog-friendly breed. And then lastly, the reason why I didn't get the Doberman Pinscher was cropping and docking. I don't want to go through the headache and the hassle of cropping and docking a dog. And for me, a Doberman Pinscher only looks right when it's cropped and docked. So I wouldn't want to go through the headache and the heartache of having to set ears and hope that they set right. To get a dog like a Rottweiler that I can keep natural, that was another big advantage for me. So again, the Doberman Pinscher is a great dog breed. It really suits my needs, but for some very subtle reasons, I chose the Rottweiler, and I'm very happy with my decision. All right, guys, this is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. Please go ahead and hit the like button and check out my other channel, The Roddy King. I'll be producing some original content for that channel very, very shortly. All right, guys, take it easy. Peace.